A few thoughts now on the lack of leadership in the House. House Intelligence Committee Chairman Devin Nunes today caving to pressure from Dems and temporarily stepping down from the committee's investigation. Speaker Ryan saying he supports Nunes's decision, yet neither the Speaker nor Nunes gave the White House the courtesy of a call. I believe this move is just the latest example of weak leadership in the House, caving to Dems, the Republican House leaders seemingly hell-bent on demonstrating they can't find a way to be consistently street smart, clever, courageous, or even courteous. Speaker Ryan's tenure as Speaker began with an air of inadequacy hanging over the House as the then new Speaker eagerly caved to President Obama on a spending bill. Never mind Speaker Ryan's promise in 2015 to return to regular order, only to bring the SAFE Act to the floor weeks later without committee hearings or amendments. He failed to garner enough GOP votes to pass a budget in 2016. And despite the Speaker's repeated assurances for weeks that he had the votes, he repeated his pattern of failure and collapse 2 weeks ago on health care. The House Republican Conference is filled with good, well-meaning congressmen and congresswomen. But when their leader contradicts himself without so much as a blush, misrepresents the state of legislation and prospects for its passage, the conference itself bears great responsibility for tolerating such leadership, if you can call it that. Given President Trump's ambitious legislative goals for them and for the country, infrastructure, tax reform, and yes, even health care, Republicans have, it seems to me, a moral responsibility to turn to new, smarter, stronger leaders with far more integrity, far more courage, and capability. This president and the country deserve far better.